We got a new vinyl, we got some old vinyl, and we got a package in the mail with some VCLT coming right up. All right, Jeff here. Anyway, got a couple things in the mail this week. Wanted to show them off a little. So let's just jump right into it. First off, we got the new Tourniquet Gazing at Medusa. I believe I might have shown maybe I did or didn't show the CD a while back. I think I did when I did the Tourniquet special. If you weren't one of the ones that followed the fundraiser for this, you may not be aware that the fundraiser for this started, what, like 2016? It was a long time ago, a couple years back, maybe even older, I don't know. They had a lot of problems, a lot of setbacks getting the album recorded, but it finally was done. It's so long back that I actually, when I crowdfunded this, I did not get the vinyl. I wasn't into vinyl at that point. I wanted to be into it, but I wasn't. I crowdfunded for the CD. But then when I got back into vinyl like a year or so later, I contacted them, even though the campaign was over, and said, hey, can I upgrade to the vinyl? And they said, sure. So I did a couple more years, and here we go. I did get the one that is, I guess, what's called the deluxe edition. So it's got, if you could see that, because it's black on kind of dark, but it's, autographed there by Ted, the drummer. And then the actual vinyl is a splatter, which looks really cool. Looked really cool online. Oh, I didn't put it back in the thing right. So it's kind of a black and goldish, brownish vinyl. Came out really nice and sounds amazing. So I believe I have up to date all of the vinyl that Tourniquet has released. They just had a crowdfunder for the newish reissue, was it 25th edition? Anyway, of one of their other vinyls, and that, I think they said they're getting the vinyl in any day now. So that one went pretty fast. So looking forward to that. That'll be just a reissue on 180 gram vinyl for that. Then I went over to the store, one of the stores I think I'd mentioned in the past, where I took a bunch of books and traded them in, got a store credit. So I went over there and said, hey, let's spend some store credit. It was a rainy day. And I think I love you. I got some Partridge Family. Hey, I think I love you. So what am I so afraid of? I'm afraid that I'm not sure of. A love there is no cure for. Weird, huh? I've shown them in the past. If you've watched my videos in the past, you know I'm a Partridge Family and David Cassidy fan. So I picked up this. It was the first, and I think I mentioned before that I had seen this over there and wanted to go back and get it, but it's the first album from 1972, and the vinyl was just, I've seen a lot of copies of this, which usually tend to be really beat up and everything, but this version was very clean, and the vinyl is just superb, so I couldn't pass it up. I did pass it up for a couple months, actually, and I kept going back saying I should get that. I finally did. So not only did I pick up that, but I picked up one of the other ones, Notebook. Now this one also was in excellent condition, had been there for a couple months. So these two, I'd been kind of hemming and hauling around about wanting to get, the covers got a little wear there, but vinyl-wise, it's very good. So I was like, well, let me go back and take a look. And the only reason I did it was because, boom, they had a third one. I thought, okay, I just need to go ahead and get these. There's, three. So this is, again, one of their, and this one was in real good shape too. So I think I've got one or two other ones of these. So I've got like four or five of theirs on vinyl. So I'm a happy boy. I don't know, something about this time period. Maybe it's the innocence. Maybe it's the just the melodies. It's the 70s and it's got that kind of love and real, fun, uplifting type stuff. So, I enjoy that. Now, the other thing that kind of, I grew up watching the reruns on TV as a kid. Maybe they weren't reruns I think they were, because I don't think I saw them in prime time. But later in life, like about 15 years ago, I don't know, whenever they released them on DVD, I purchased all of them. And I watched those, you know, from my childhood and everything. But the other thing was my oldest son watched them with me. And so we ended up every night coming back and sitting down and watching, you know, ended up going through all the seasons there together. And he enjoyed it. And he enjoyed the music and everything. And, of course, that's a son that's no longer with us. So, you know, there's that sentimental value there where, and I got to say, I haven't watched them since his passing. So, but I do listen to music, still like the music. But kind of feel like that was our thing. I'll eventually get back to watch them because I want to get the younger kids who were way too young at that point. I'd like to see them get into it and watch it. They have to listen to the music with me in the car so they know some of the music. But anyway, I picked up one other thing. My favorite Kansas album, Vinyl Confession. They had this, and it was in very good condition. This is like the one with John Elefante. I think this was the first one. Oh, it's also a gold stamp promo, which, again, I don't put much stock in, but, you know, whatever. There, it's there. And so this is John Elefante joined the band on this release. He did a couple with them. And this was just one of the ones. Had Play the Game Tonight, which was on MTV back in the day. But this is the one that, it's weird, because this is the one that's, it's hard to find. It tends to be, at least when I was looking for it on CD, it's not like been reissued and all that back in the day. So, I don't know, maybe they just ignored it, but I saw it on vinyl. I'm like, I'm going to get it, because it is one of my favorites. Now, then I got a package in the mail a couple days from our very own vinyl community, mega monster, singer, screamer, Scott Waters, and we had been communicating back and forth on some things and some upcoming projects and stuff that he was doing, and he's like, hey, do you need this, or hey, do you have that, hey, I'm going to send me some stuff. And I already showed some of the stickers and stuff he sent, I think in my last video, actually. And in my last video, I showed some of the photos I had, which he's big into collecting photos, so we started talking, you know, and I had some extras, so I sent them to him, and he had a couple more that he sent to me. First off, let's just throw some CDs in here. These are just some things I'm assuming he had laying around, but that I did not have physical copies of. I'm assuming these are extras he had laying around. Extreme, Three Sides to Every Story, and Porno Graffiti. Extreme were one of those bands that I kind of missed out on. I mean, I've listened to them since then, but I don't have any. I had never really purchased any of their stuff. They were during that time frame where I had gotten out of mainstream music and was listening to just the Christian rock and stuff. So that was the late 80s into the early 90s. So that was one of those bands I missed. He tossed me in a copy of the Conviction, the Pain EP. This is some really cool stuff. You know, it's raw and, you know, but it's got some good riffs on here. So I was appreciative of that, to have that. And then he had this, which is fun, odd, Stars That Move. I discovered these guys and gal a couple years back, and I think I have digital copies of this, plus their one that followed after this. Kind of a doom type band, but he had a copy of this still sealed, and I'm like, well, I have it digitally, but not physically, so yes, I'll take that. And then a copy of Metal Church's 11 album. Again, I had this one digitally, but never had to find the actual physical product. And then it comes to the photos. This is what the main thing was we were dealing with. So, and some of these I was not expecting, like the one for Fear Not. This is obviously a newer picture, and I don't know if it was supposed to go with that or if it was a last minute thing that they added, but I was excited to see that. I don't have any photos of the Crucified, so was glad to see this. Been a Crucified fan since I discovered them on cassette back in the day. Actually, the other day, before he even sent that, I pulled out the set that I have, that box set where it's got their albums, the demos, and a bunch of video footage. So I was watching a bunch of the footage from that, and then he sends me that. And then the next three are all band pictures of his band, Ultimatum, which he sent me one of the other ones before, but these are some other shots from various years. And look, he signed that one, because I think I made comment of it last time. Hey, why don't you sign a picture? So it's just some other different photos from the band. And again, nice little autograph there. Makes it so special. Anyway, and that was about it. was excited to get some extra stuff there and some more photos to put away and stuff. And that's it for now. So thanks for watching, and I'll be back soon.